Today I'm going to explain and demonstrate what hexagonal architecture is and how we can use it in GoLang. The hexagonal architecture, also referred to as ports and adapters, is an architectural pattern that allows input by users or external systems to arrive into application at a port via an adapter. I'll explain through the file structure. This file structure is standard Go project layout by Go community, not official, but mostly recommend. What we have inside is mostly hexagonal architecture file structure. Let's start demonstrate from internal folder. Inside the internal folder, we would have many app services. So that means you can do modular monitoring by copying and renaming the app folder. For instance, TODO for a TODO service and auth for authentication. Also, each folder have hexagonal file structure. So what we have inside app folder? Let's start explaining by adapters. We have input and output folders. There are many advantages of using the ports and adapters architecture. One of them is to be able to completely isolate your application logic and domain logic in a fully testable way. Let's start with input folder. The input or primary adapters use the input ports to trigger the execution of use cases. For example, in a mobile application, when a user clicks a button, relevant adapter should call the input adapter to request for the associated use case. Output or driven adapters. All the driven adapters will be placed in a packages inside the directory output folder. Core folder. We have very basic stuffs over here. One of is domain you will familiar with, and the other one is port where the relation happens. Domain folder. All the domain models will be placed inside this directory. It contains the Go struct definition of each entity that is part of the domain problem and can be used across the application. Ports folder. It contains interfaces definition used to communicate with actors. Finally, services folder. These services are our entry points to the core, and each one of them implements the corresponding core. Up this point, we generally grasp the concept of hexagonal architecture. Let's solidify the understanding with demonstration. Let's get our hands dirty. Let's say we are developing a microservice app. The part of this app is skills. Before it gets into the coding, let's demonstrate our app. In this app, we need to have a route that allows the client to get into app. So that means we need to have a controller. When the user requests to app, to skills, we need to do some business logic. In this business logic, what we lack is the data. So how can we obtain it? We need a repository to get data. Let's start API first. First and foremost, we need to establish a collection for our microservice. This entails creating a route dedicated to retrieving skills. Our aim with this route is to return a list of skills. We will focus on obtaining this response to fulfill our task at hand. Alright, now let's start coding. To display skills, we require a skill entity. Let's proceed to create. We already familiar with the skill schema from the collection. Let's simply copy and paste it over. Let's consider a scenario where our data provider presents the data in a completely different format. For instance, they might use CTG instead of category. I'll explain the significance of this situation later on. Now, let's prepare the response schema. We can simply copy and paste from the collection again, ensuring it remains consistent because this is the format we intend to return to the user. Once we retrieve the data from the provider, such as MySQL, we will need to convert it to match the response schema. To begin, let's create a builder for our response schema. Now we can proceed to write our builder. It's a straightforward task. To get skills from data provider, so we will create a repository port. Also, we need to have a service port for providing data for controller. Let's write our repository. The SQL repository should implement the SQL repository port interface. Also, we will embed entity repository to use ORM instance. Now, we are ready to write our use case. Let's write a skill service struct depends repository. The skill service should implement the skill service port interface. We mostly developed our service. Now let's proceed to finalize it by writing our handler file, which manages the incoming requests. But firstly, let me write this thing. The final step will be to edit into the request file. Let's test it. Okay. So, let's test from Postman. Since we don't have any data on database, we get an empty array. That's it. Well done. Throughout this video, I've discussed what hexagonal architecture is and how you can utilize it within your projects. I hope you find it informative and enjoyable. Happy coding!